I'm just wondering if you can see what I can see here. I can get 41 volts out of this at the minute. We have 45.9 going in. If I had to turn that down, it says we've got 51 going in. So I turn this up to 58 volts. See up there. And then if I start doing this, turn this up on 13 volts. I get 68 watts. Try not to. Hey there YouTube. Now I said I was going to do this little experiment with this DPS 5015 that I got in here, and I did try to do it, and I was using a 650 watt power supply, but for some reason I couldn't get any more than 60 watts out of it. In the end I figured it was the power supply might be faulty, so I took apart this little supply that I made with the LCT 3780, whatever it is. I'll correct that because I probably said it wrong, because I had this connected into it. So I took that apart and I've connected this power supply into the back of here. So if I switch that off, so there's no output, then we've got a little power light, and if I switch this off, the little power light goes out. Put it back on again. Okay. And I also put in some outputs here, which they're connected directly to the input of this switch. This is a double pole, double throw switch, so I can have the two inputs going here and it's completely isolated. When I switch up, I've got now input to here, but if I keep that off, it just has the inputs to here. Okay, yeah, so we've got outputs to here, sorry. So I switch this on, because it's a boost converter, it has to, it can only have the minimum of what the input is, which is basically 12 volts coming from this unit here. Yeah, this is an ATx power supply, 500 watts. So I thought to myself, okay, I'll use directly from the output here, and we come down to the power connections to my little circuit here. Let me give you some more light. It's my little circuit with my inductor coil on. Now, at the minute, I've got this 4-turn coil on here, which uses the least amount of current. Is that my 4 or 3? Oh, I'm sorry, it could be my 3. Yeah, it's my 3-turn. So this doesn't quite use the least amount of current, but it doesn't use as much current as a 2-turn, and it certainly doesn't use as much current as a single turn. And what I was going to do first was I was just going to connect it directly to this boost converter. And you got to remember, off the boost converter as well as this display. Yeah, so we're going to connect it up directly to that. So if I just get this wire and clip that on there. As you can see, we've got oscillation. It's pulling 150 milliamps. It's actually pulled the input power down very, very slightly. But that could just be because there's a bit of a load there now. It should be just under 12 volts. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to just gently turn this up, because this is a single turn pot and it can go all the way up to 85 volts. So I'm just going to gently start turning that up. Okay, so the reason why that's doing that is because this lamp's on, I'm close to it. So we've got a good oscillation over there, you see on the scope. LED's on. There's no breakout at this point, so I'm just going to force that. Okay, so there's just a little tiny bit of breakout. So we've got 21 volts at 0.6 amps. If I start going up, but look what happens to my display. The display doesn't like that. It's dimming down quite considerably on the display. Breakout started. Oscillation's good. It is trying to say now that that's 30 volts at one point. There's no way that that's like 45 watts. Anyway, so we'll just turn it up a slight more. I don't want to break it, but look how much that sort of dims out. It's pretty much nothing. I'm going to turn that back down again now. Because obviously that's not happy. Well, that's okay. It was just an experiment anyway. So I'm going to disconnect that from there, if I can. Disconnect that, and I'm going to show you that the display still works. And I should still be able to turn up this boost converter. All the way to about 85 volts. We get that on the output there. That 85 will now be on the output there. I can show you that by connecting up my just bear with me. Pop that back there. I'll just put it at an angle that you can see it. If I just chuck these two probes. Just chuck that in there. Just chuck that in there. I hope you can see down there. Only 5.47 volts. Which is close enough to what it says there. Okay, so I'm going to turn that back down again. If I turn it all the way down, I know that we've got basically what the input voltage is and a very slight boost. But of course, that's not what we want to be using to power this. We really want to be using this. So if I move that out of the way and I plug it in over here. Now the nice thing about this unit is it's until you press the power button, which is underneath here, it doesn't come on. Now at the minute it looks like it's set to, I think it says 18 volts, so I'm just gonna set that. Just drop that all the way down to zero. Because I like starting off with it on zero. Okay, go back to the voltage. Oh sorry, go back to there. And now I can press on the voltage one again, press here a couple of times, and I can start taking the voltage up. He says here, I can start taking the voltage up. Oh, I've got to turn it on first, that's a good idea. So we start taking the voltage up. So 3.4 volts, and we've got oscillation over there. So we know we're working, that's before anything breaking out. I think for some reason we seem to be, oh I see, that's because I've got to turn up the input voltage. I'm being a bit of a let me just turn up that input voltage. So let's give it a, there you go, 40 volts, and we can start turning this up, and we get past that 12 volt stage. So we got oscillation over there, our little LEDs come on, got no breakout as yet, we've got breakout now. So I should be able to get probably about 36 volts out of this with a 40 volt input. And it's basically saying there that we got a oscillation that doesn't look too terrible. Got the breakout. LED's working. And now we got a 1 amp nearly at 34 volts. which has just gone up to 1.2. Bit of a jump. Don't really like it when things like that start happening. But if I press this button again. Okay. Can't really turn it up any higher just because the input voltage needs to go up. But I don't want to turn up the input voltage too high while it's on the load, because it will show a different voltage, and then when I turn it down it could overvolt this and kill it. Maximum 60 volts this can go up to. So if I put 58.5 volts to that, I start turning up again. Break out there. Well, now we can get nearly 70 watts. Nearly 70 watts. We get 40 volts, 1.7 amps, 69.2 watts. Well, that seems to be all I can actually get out of this, like this. But I'll be able to get more if I change this. This is what's holding this back now. That's why I've got a few coils, because now if I want to draw more power and get this to give up more of a display, I need to adjust that, or I can put some capacitance on, because there's no capacitance on this circuit at the moment. Now part of the reason why I wanted to do this was because the warranty from AliExpress for this is run out. I've not had it a month and it's already run out. So basically if I kill it, I'm on my own. Or if I kill it, I'm on my own to the point of where I still got a bit of time with PayPal, because I paid, I'm pretty sure, with PayPal. I like to pay with PayPal because you get a bit of an extended warranty. And the reason why I say it like that is because I think you get like 60 days or something. But it can take up to 45 days to get to you, which, if you're a shop reselling these things, that's no good at all, of course, because it could be on the shelf for a month, let's say. But if you're just an individual buying them, that's okay. But, so as you can see here, I mean, it says there what we're drawing, 69 watts, and that probably tallies up to around about that as well. Let's say 45 times 1.5 is 45 plus the half, well, that would be another sort of 20, so 65, 70, about 70 watts, yeah. So, but what I'm going to do now is, looking at these numbers, that's the maximum I can do with that input. I'm going to put a capacitor on there and we're going to see what we can do with that. Annoyingly, you have to keep pressing this set button whenever you want to change this. It can be a bit annoying. It'd be nice if it just stayed, so you can just turn it up and down as you wish. You know, in case you've got a bit of a panic on, or something's happening that you don't want to happen. So I'm going to now turn the output off on that. And I'm going to add some capacitance to this circuit. We're going to see what the difference is between that and that. So just bear with me just while I just add that. Right, so what we've got going on. So what I've done is I've put this 10 millifarad on, just to see what it's like. Let's put some light on the subject. 10 millifarads, and we're gonna still got the same 58.3 volts, and none of this has changed. So I'm gonna turn the output on. I'm gonna do this set thing so we can turn it up. So 3 volts, let's have a look at there is oscillation at 3 volts, 4 volts, and the next one is gonna be the breakout. And that this coil is about 25 volts, there we go, as expected. Let's just turn it up as far as it will go. Oh, summer just went pop, or did make a little noise. Wouldn't be surprised if that's that pasta, but summer just did a little pop. I don't know if you could have heard that on the actual video. I did. And there's no real difference. So we're doing exactly the same on Oh, that's me again, let's just shift that out of the way. And we're going exactly the same over there. Just shift those out of the way. Exactly the same there. 69.78, so it's slightly higher. 1.68 amps. I love looking at this, especially, I don't know how close or how detailed that is that you can see. But for me it's quite detailed, and I quite like the look of it. Anyway, let's turn this back down again, so we're going to press this set button, we're going to press this, press this, and then we can start winding it down, because you don't want to just turn the power off, because there's going to be a lot of energy in this coil, and it's going to want to go somewhere. So it's nice to turn it all down, to settle it all down. Okay, so our output now, we can turn that off. And that's all the same. Now what I'm going to do now, is I'm going to change this coil up. And I'm going to put the two-turn coil in. Put this two-turn coil in. And although it probably looks terrible, it's because it's just a piece of copper wire and with some electrical tape around it to insulate it from each other and everything else. I'm going to stick that in. Hopefully that's connected nicely and not touching anything that it shouldn't be. Let's give it a go, turn the output power on there. Let the green run out. Let's hit these buttons. Oh, gotta turn that up. Okay. Oscillation straight away. It's just a little look actually. So 4 volts, 3.99. It says there when we get the oscillation. See what the breakout voltage is. We're on 17 volts, 19 volts. Okay, so the breakout voltage is. Oh, let me just turn it down again. 17 volts, 19 volts, 20 volts breakout. Okay, so let's turn it up. Now we're on 1.6 amps and we're only on 30 volts this time. We're drawing nearly 1 amp over here, 57 volts still, on 50 watts. We're 34 volts, 36 volts. Right, we're on 72 watts at 2.2 amps. I can't go any higher than that. We're at nearly 2 amps, nearly 80 watts over on the boost converter. 73 there. We can't really go up any higher. So I'm going to turn it down all the way. I'm just going to change that capacitor and put this 0.27 back on. So cross in and see what happens now with that smaller capacitor. So we've got a breakout, so that's, well, it's what we can see it over there because the way I've got that set up. 4 volts again. See where we get our breakout. 17 volts, 18 volts, 19 volts, 20 volts. There we go. There's probably going to be absolutely no difference really. Well, let me just turn that down just for a second actually. I just want to check something. I just want to see how warm that is. Ah, we're alright. Let's turn it back up again. Get past that 19, 20, 25, 33. 33, so that's 36 volts. 73 watts. I have to keep in mind as well that the difference there isn't really that great deal, but then for this you have to leave it going a little bit for it to start oscillating itself, so you get more of a prettier pattern out of this. But considering there's only 4 extra watts that's been taken off there, it's not a great deal really. We've already got 2 amps at that voltage. It's a pity that you can't actually get the voltage to go up any higher. This is being pulled down here to 40 volts, look. So, anyway, let's turn this back down. As you can see, look, I can't really turn up the input voltage anymore. Okay, I had to think, but it was only for about a second or two, and then what I thought was actually what I'm going to do is I'm gonna put this on top, because this is my little where we get some of this stuff flying off. So I'm just going to coil this slightly so it sits underneath. I'll just do it like a pig's tail slightly, so I just want that to sit on top. Now, there's a good possibility this circuit won't work now, because it tends to do that. It tends to sort of play up a little bit when I'm doing this sort of stuff. So let's see if we can get it oscillating to start off with. Okay, so I just turn it up. We've got 5 volts. There we go. We got an oscillation. That's good. But it took it 2, 3, 4 sort of. 4 volts. We got that oscillation. Okay, so we're not really going to get breakout as what we've seen before, but what we will be able to do is the old favourite slide. Let's just put that there for a second. I'll go and get it. As we can see, we can get the tube to light up, which we can. That's not very bright at all, but then it's only doing 1.2 watts. So if I just pop that up there and position this in such a way, I'm just going to try and some sort of backstop. Now that's all metal, that's probably not a good idea for me to be using that. So let me just pop that there and just swap that out for that glass. That glass, it's where I put, the clippings off components and just push them. So, what's this here? We've got 10 volts, 120 milliamp, 1.2 watts, which adds up quite well. Let's turn that up just slightly. That's all these blue buttons again. So okay, we got 3 watts coming off this now. Oh, that's nice and bright. It's just flipped up. I suppose if you had a 24 volt supply going into that, now that says it's 30 watts, 1.2 amps. So where's my? So we get anything off here? We do. Not a great deal. I suppose we're using some of that up in drops it down to sort of 10, 15 watts. And I was just trying to see what it does over there on the power supply. Pulls it down 57. Actually, it says it actually goes up in voltage to 58 volts there. No, it's 57. That's quite a bright LED strip lamp. It's a bigger than all, it's 4 foot, I think that is. But that's using 30 watt power. You can see that. So, not quite sure how many watts in this, these strip lamps would be anyway, for lighting things up. That doesn't seem that efficient really. But let me just adjust this. I suppose I could turn it up a little bit and just see what we can do. That's 50, that's sort of 60 watts. Not that massively different, 2 amps. But look at the voltage staying up over there, look. I've still got 57. 57. Oh, it's going down a bit. That's maybe as I'm getting closer, it's no, but as I got closer to the actual coil, maybe it does make a little bit of erratic. So I'm just gonna turn this down. Okay, so that's 12 volts, 107540. Just turn that off a second. Move that out of the way. Just put it in there. Do something to put on the top for a little bit of breakout. This is a soldering iron tip that I used the other day for cutting some gunk stuff in my quadcopter. So let's turn that up and see if we get a breakout on the top. So I'm at 10 volts, 1.3 watts, 30 milliamps, 12 volts. So we've got, might have to induce the breakout. Okay, so that says 50 volts, 50 watts. So let's just see. Okay, I've got to induce the breakout a little bit there. And I also need to keep a check on temperature. So I'm just going to turn this down just while I do that check on temperature. Let's just. We'll be alright, just to give it a little bit of an experiment and see how. We're going to see, let it break out for itself. So we're on 20 volts, 21 volts. Let's just see, 22 volts. I'm going to turn this off over here. Okay, so it's breaking out for itself around about 28 volts. Ah, now, up to 30 volts, and that's 60 watts practically. We're still on sort of 58 volts, 1.1 amps. But as soon as I go above that 30 volts, we're down to 50, 51, 48. We're going up now, we're just dropping on the other side. We're down to 37 now. So the maximum I'm going to get out of there is about 75 watts. We've got 2 amps, 37 volts. And you can see that. And a piddly bit of breakout, really. Power supply, you know, doesn't feel warm, or there's no warm air coming out of it, really. But that's 70 watts going through the little wires up there, going through to the switch and stuff, probably might be getting warm in here. And I don't have any fans to expel air out the back either, so let's just turn that down a bit, because that's still 75 watts, still quite a bit of energy. Okay, so I've got to be able to try and, well, I've got to be able to give this more power, it seems, and this unit here is seeming like, as it's dropping, it's because it's not getting enough power from this unit here, which is interesting. And it might also mean that the power supply that I was using before, which is a 650 watt power supply, may not have issues as such. I thought it got issues because this is doing practically the same thing as what that one was. So I don't know what to think about that. Now I need to have that little rethink. So I'll be back in a bit.